Thank you for the opportunity to present our findings. The growing demand for access to space and for services on Earth provided by space activity is increasing congestion and leading towards models of greater autonomy by space actors. In other domains where space activity is subject to a sovereign authority, this increase in activity is managed through centralized regulation or operational restriction. But as we all know, there is no sovereign authority over space. Each spacefaring nation bears responsibility for continuing supervision, but at the same time, individual space actors bear the tactical responsibility for collision avoidance. But do they have enough information about each other to successfully meet this obligation? When the risk was debris, the answer was sensors. When the risk is congestion, detection is not enough. The answer is shared information. Information sharing, either between space actors that don't particularly like each other, is not new. But if it is goal-driven, we can overcome obstacles. In 1975, the Apollo-Soyuz test project successfully joined two distinct space vehicles with different designs, technologies, life support systems, and engineering from two countries who were not only in competition, but critical of the other's engineering, governing, and political philosophy. How? They were willing to identify and share just that information that was necessary to achieve their common goal. Safely joining the Apollo and Soyuz capsules to enable the handshake in space. From that, we get Shuttle Mir and later ISS, because we demonstrated that cooperation is possible. Space information sharing is not new, but like Apollo-Soyuz, it remains predominantly bilateral. There are a lot of bilateral agreements. Space information is exchanged between many space actors, space data providers, space data consumers, and some actors or both. Trust is based on the relationship between the parties at either end of the agreement. But this is fundamentally an asymmetric approach to information sharing. The problem is not unique to space. The problem of asymmetric access to information is well established in economics and international relations. Market failures are often attributed to asymmetric access to information. However, achieving symmetric access to relevant information across a global domain requires a mechanism to establish trust between those providing the data and those consuming the data, whether or not a bilateral relationship exists. Industry consortia, like the Space Data Association and the EU-SST, recognize the need to share information on space operations that goes beyond sensor drive data. These voluntary consortia demonstrate the value of increased information sharing. While this mechanism creates trust among participants within each consortia, there remains a need for entities that are not within a specific consortia and between independent consortia to share information with each other. An ongoing study at Laval University is examining polycentricity in space governance through bilateral agreements. To date, they have identified and examined more than 931 data sharing arrangements, and the majority of the agreements found by this team do not include a US party, either public or private. This clearly illustrates the community's desire for information sharing outside the dominant US structures. Trust is a challenge. While space data sharing consortia can reach high levels of participation, there will always be a barrier to universal participation because there is an inherent distrust of a structure where one entity has control over the information. It raises questions of resilience, vulnerability, and we cannot ignore geopolitical rivalries. A decentralized model is necessary to overcome these barriers. The emergence of a de facto model of governance through bilateral agreements has significant limitations and reinforces the premise that a stakeholder-driven decentralized model is necessary. Moving to a technology-enabled information sharing model delivers tangible value. It is not unique to the space community. We are seeing this value in other domains: self-driving cars, smart cities, aviation, and supply chains. We found some very clear examples in this research that illustrates both safety and capacity enhancements. In this study of self-driving cars, we see that while vehicles are equipped with collision avoidance sensors, it provides some capacity benefit. But when the vehicles are communicating with the surrounding vehicles, we more than triple highway capacity. In aviation, the use of ADS-B in a system that allows general aviation aircraft to receive a data feed, sharing ATC weather and traffic information from the FAA, there is an estimated 58% reduction in collision risk and an 89% reduction in fatal accident risk. the applications and benefits go beyond safety and capacity, reaching into diplomacy and norms development. I will hand this over to my colleague, Dr. Nate Dailey, to elaborate.
Thank you, Ruth. So building on the previous slide, technology-enabled information sharing also has an affinity for building diplomatic capacity in the space domain, especially among those working towards establishing norms for the use of space that are designed to enhance trust and confidence-building measures. This is where transparency comes into play in international relations among the spacefaring community. Put succinctly, this connection, technology-enabled information sharing and building space diplomatic capacity, is a socio-technological transformative mechanism. This connection establishes a platform-agnostic framework to serve space-related conversations across national boundaries and allows the reconciliation of differences from across cultural divides. This framework's neutrality is with regard to the nature of the conversation, but directed towards functionality. For example, interoperability, access to space for all, rights to space resources, preservation of the space environment, space power, and so on. The platform allows stakeholders of the space domain to engage in such broad and impartial discussions. This agnostic framework can be put to many uses, but the fact that it is a tool and independent of those uses is its most significant value to constructive engagement in the global spacefaring community. Like those other times in history, the establishment of the Law of the Seas and the fall of the Berlin Wall, we are now at a new inflection point, but this time in the use of outer space. Next slide, please. And so these are some of the conditions that come about as an outcome and impact of having established norms for space use. But rhetoric alone won't yield results necessary now or in the future of the space domain. Clarity of understanding is a fundamental condition. And then, little by little, information sharing systems can begin to automate microprocesses, allowing human interaction to focus on the important things. This builds space traffic management capacity, but also in turn, diplomatic capacity. The final impact are conditions of peace and stability. And so, like those enumerated on this slide. For a more in-depth discussion on affinity ecosystems, I'll hand it over to you, Harvey.
Thank you, Nate. And here we see some of the different aspects of what we mean by an affinity ecosystem. Number one, the most important part is the stakeholders who participate. That would be everyone in space, especially when we want to share space safety information. Each of the stakeholders can publish and everyone else can read all the information, so there's no subsetting of information as in the present mode of operation. People that publish, they can publish to any node and all the nodes share the information. The nodes capture and protect the information so that if somebody scribbles on the data, then that's detected, so corruption is cryptographically assured. And if some of the nodes get impacted by accident or attack, the other nodes still have all the data, so the data cannot be destroyed. So this leads to a capability which has the potential to be both trusted, you know, the data is secure, and symmetric. Everybody gets to see all the different information. Next slide. So what we want to do here with this presentation is give everybody a call to action. And the call to action is to join us in research. And the research seeks to next start on prototypes of this concept, now that this concept has been fleshed out with a number of space SMEs. You can please contact me, or even better, next slide. You can contact any of these authors and all the other SMEs who are collaborating with us. And we look forward to seeing you at a future space event. Thank you.